On Wednesday, September 12, 2018, Apple COO Jeff Williams got on stage at the Steve Jobs Theater and announced that the Apple Watch Series 4 would come with a built-in ECG, or electrocardiogram, giving the user the ability to see the real-time electrical activity happening in their heart. Well, sort of. It's technically a rhythm strip, but whatever. This has never been built directly into a wearable before, and it's what scientists would call a big frickin' deal. While the accuracy of the reading is for sure gonna be tested in the future, it begs the question, what's the difference between this $400 accessory and a full-fledged 12-lead ECG? Some quick background info. Heart disease is the number one killer in the Western world, so there's a need to find arrhythmias, or abnormal heart rhythms. To diagnose arrhythmias, a doctor will choose to use a full-blown electrocardiogram, usually after a life-threatening event or when they suspect something's wrong. In the hospital, the medical team will attach adhesive electrodes in strategic places around your chest and abdomen to get a good recording of pulses, and different pairings of electrodes produce what's called a lead to make the industry-standard 12-lead ECG that looks like this. Great for use in the hospital, but what about when patients are living their regular lives? Smaller, portable ECG units have been available for a while, but they'd still only be prescribed for a short period of time and only if there's a suspicion of finding something. So with any portable unit, you lose the detail from a full 12 lead, but what you lose in detail, you gain in the continuity. For your everyday wearable health tech like the Apple Watch or a Fitbit, the big advantage is the continuous monitoring for people who might not know they have a heart condition. But while those little green light sensors on previous Apple Watches can pick up the number of beats, they don't tell you anything about the underlying electrical activity that caused it. So to get that info without having to stick somebody up with chest electrodes, developers got the user's opposite hand involved so they could complete a circuit. And the first company to do this successfully for a consumer product was a brand called AliveCore, which made a watch band for the Apple Watch that had an electrode built into the band. The user wears the watch on one hand and closes the circuit with the opposite one. The new Series 4 model does this, but with the digital crown instead of a separate band. But when watching the Jeff Williams presentation and reading some of the articles that came out afterwards, you notice that the common arrhythmia that they mention is atrial fibrillation, or AFib. That's because they have the validation of a bunch of really smart people who have been testing this in the background for a few years. A 2018 study published in the Journal of the American Medical Association Cardiology took data from almost 10,000 participants with heart rate trackers like the old Apple Watch, devices that only give us heart rate and time, which give us graphs that look like this. While these patterns don't give us a full ECG waveform, they can still give us hints as to what's going on. Atrial fibrillation looks like this on an ECG. Lots of little waveforms that we can notice instead of the nice discrete waveforms of normal sinus rhythm. The study used neural networks and machine learning to learn when it could say, this pattern on the watch data usually goes with AFib on an ECG. Then they took that data and applied it to 51 patients undergoing cardioversion, procedure that helps restore a normal electrical rhythm in the heart. The study concluded that with this technology, they could find AFib with about a 97% accuracy. Knowing this, the hope is that the watch will pick up on something and then alert the user to go to the doctor where they then get a real deal diagnosis. And with the blessing of the American Food and Drug Administration, as well as the president of the American Heart Association giving his personal testimony for the product, there's a lot of trust behind these results. And Apple is actually still studying this alongside Stanford Medicine. That study is set to finish in January of 2019. Going forward, it'll still be a while before more complex arrhythmias will be detectable, and a $400 watch isn't gonna touch what hospital-grade equipment can do. But the fact that we now have a tool for screening one of the most common arrhythmias that people have in a product that people are gonna buy is a huge deal. Thank you very much for watching. This is a bit different than my typical anatomy and physiology videos, but the shiny new tech was too much to resist. So make sure to check out some of my other videos and subscribe if you're interested. Either way, have a great day. Have fun, be good. I'll see you next time.